Hey guys, Nick here today, and this is Creative Writing Tips 101. Yeah. So, I haven't done one of these creative writing in a bit, and I wanted to do another one. This one is to make short stories. Now, first things first, you're gonna. I'm actually recording this because my internet crashed, and I had. This because I plugged in my other. I just saw this and I will play it. That'll be my next video. Anyway, I just plugged in my other hard drive and I transferred all the files. Except I still have some from my laptop from a long time ago. Like, those are important files. I don't need them right now. It's mostly pictures for ideas, because. That's what the characters in my book look like. Doesn't matter right now. Right now, the video is short story tips. Now, short stories aren't like normal stories. They're short, so you gotta keep that in mind. So, the first tip is... One sec. Let me extend my list of tips. Okay, so I just took like 10 seconds. And recording? Yes. I took, 10 seconds just to quickly compile a list. A quick 5 list. I have some more in the other one. Let me just save this as... No, I don't need to save it right now. What was that game? Part 1, book ideas. Part 12. No, number 12. Okay, first things first, don't waste time developing characters. If it's, like, a very short story, you're only gonna have... like a paragraph or less to describe your character, and you don't want to like waste more time developing it and having people get to really know and connect it. You can't really do that within the short span of a short story. Low character and item count. Low character and item count. You don't want to be, you know, starting the book with like 50 characters and you expect everyone to remember it. Like, over time people can get to remembering characters from the book if they keep recurring, or if they have distinctive features and they keep recurring, or if the moment of their occurrence is just very large. Now, that's not really gonna be able to happen in if your story is short. Because you can't really make lots of characters that keep on appearing on and on. The same with the items. Like, you can't have, if you say you're doing magic, I guess you could, but you know, it would be sort of a waste of time to have like 50 magical items, because you have to come up with all the items, and then you're probably only going to be able to use it like once in the span of the book. Not a lot of wiggle room. What I mean by that is, like, you can't really expect to have, like, you know, be able to... Okay, well, once you get started, sort of have a base, and it's not that easy to change things because, you know, it's short and you won't be able to rewrite stuff or go back on what you said without, you know, explaining it, because you're going to want to explain it, but you can't do that because that would just be wasting. Don't jump around, like, don't have like 7 perspectives if your story's only like 5 pages long, because then that's not even a perspective per page. So try and keep it like a single perspective, or you know, the third person omniscient or whatever, omniscient, I don't remember what it's called. I haven't taken language arts in a while. Because it's summer, yay, are you ready for the summer? Anyway, try not to jump around at different locations and people. If it's like a group of people, and you're doing a third person, then you could sort of get it all together like that, and that would good. Don't use filler, like, try and waste time, because you're not gonna have much, really, to start with, because it's a short story, and it's short. But now that we're past that, don't like saying, let's get on to the actual thing. Okay, so first things first, you're gonna wanna choose, like a genre. That's not. I had a list of genres. I guess I forgot it. Here's a quick way to get. I'm uploading videos and some other. Okay. Now you know my internet provider. Ah, you can see the IP chicken. Oh well. Okay. What's it? Oh right. Just list of genres. If you really need a list of genres, and just Wikipedia. Now, I suggest you choose only like one if you're gonna do short story, and you're like just starting out. You're probably gonna wanna stick to one and not dabble in everything. But the more you write, the more experienced you're gonna be. So with the short stories, you're probably gonna be able to mix a lot together, more easily, make it less obvious. And you know, subtle and whatnot. But if not, it's gonna be really clear that you're trying to use lots of genres. So I only stuck to two. In this one, I could probably mix a lot more. I put anguish because then I changed what I was gonna do. I was gonna have one of the characters die. But oh well, that's not a real genre. I don't even think anguish. Okay, so I did fantasy and science fiction, which are my two favorites, which brings me to another point. Stick to what you know / are good at. Are good at. 'Cause, you know, you don't wanna, if you don't know much about romance, you don't wanna be writing a romance short story. 'Cause then it's gonna come out really horrible. That's why I write fantasy and science fiction. Or mystery, and I don't write, you know, romance, or erotic, ew. Okay, so then set, like, a goal you want. So I put, like, 10,000 pages. You could also put in words, 10,000 words. I meant 2 pages, not 10,000 pages. 2 words and 10,000 pages, ooh, that's fantastic. Anyway, done by end of video. See, the first time I did this, I hadn't typed it up yet, so it was all new. Brainstorm. Just come up with little ideas. You can make it explain things, or you could just jot it down. You know, like Peter Merlimar, character names, those two are. And that rhymed. Invisibility cape, that's an item that shall be used. Small security drones, they'll be coming after them, they're not so small. Evil Lord, Malfator. See, I could have just put Malfator, but then I might have forgotten that he was an evil lord. So I put that down. Lighthouse on deadly mountainside surrounded by tall grass. So, like, lighthouse on the mountain with the waves crushing below, and there's tall grass surrounding it, and it's very high up with rocks sticking out about, so it's deadly. Rebels, there's people sort of confronting the evil lord, and they don't want to be under his reign. Confrontation, the rebels confront them, or the family, or just some sort of confrontation where they meet the evil lord, or somewhat something like that. Secret tunnel way, they want to escape through a secret tunnel way, or something like that. So I already wrote it, and it starts with sort of, you know, introducing the characters, and sort of just telling about the home, you know, up but down the stairs. And then it sort of gives his age from his 16th birthday. That seems so long ago. In reality, it was only a few weeks. Now, you know, he's 16, and then the other guy, Peter, is his little brother, so you know he's younger than 16. And it doesn't say younger, it says little, so you know he's not like 1 year behind or two, he's like 4 or 5. And so, along with that, there's a quick rising action. Come in, close the door and pack up your stuff, his dad called out. They know we're here, where we are. We have to move out again. Punctuation is important, punctuality. Capital letters, these things, commas, yes. So he quickly packed, and then action arrives quickly, like action soon gets there. Footsteps ran down the stairs leading to the next floors on top of the lighthouse. They are here, Peter yelled, as they heard the front door shatter, because it's made out of wood, and it was like, and fell in. So, top of the lighthouse, that's what he's telling Peter. And then there's a moment where you're like, are they going to get them? And they manage to escape, get down, and they use the invisibility cloak to follow the drones to where their parents will be kidnapped, and then it sort of like climaxes, and you know, I'm not really sure what the climax is, it's just any total area, you know. Yeah, I keep saying illusion of being miles long, because oh yeah, there's a hallway and it felt like forever. And it's sort of leading up to the last moment where everything happens. It's like, oh, it feels like taking forever, and he's all nervous. You want to build up the emotion, and then it happens. I was aware you were there the whole time. So it's like, oh no, the plan has failed. But, and then it turns out to be all right. And they got him. So it's a happy ending, and it just has all this development. And then, you know, it's not much of a falling action, because it should be exposition, rising action, climax, falling action, resolution, and then like denouement or whatever. Don't worry about that. Anyway, falling action, it's sort of just saw Malfator vanish with a flash, milliseconds before, because the time slowed as the beam of light dashed through the air. Before the bullet hit him, he thought it was probably his imagination and decided to ignore it. So it could, like, leave up to an opening of something else. Like, you could put this, you could write this short story, and then you're like, man, I really like this idea. You can expand on it, comma, go above, okay, slash, actually, slash, above and beyond. So, you know, if you like how your, short story turned out, and then you can turn it into, one sec, short story tips. Then you could make it longer and make it like a book, because with this, saw him disappear, and then they all knew by the end of the day everything would be how it should be. That's sort of the resolution. But it's sort of saying that there could be another little short story, or it's leaving it up to the imagination. So maybe he did see it, maybe he didn't, or you can continue it from there and saying he didn't, and they have to, or the guy returns and takes it over while the family is, the dad is dead and it's in the future, and the kid is off on another planet, and when he gets back, you know, the guy is back, and he didn't really kill him. So, you know, you could expand on it, or you could just leave it as a short story. There's, so after you write it, even after, there's still possibilities with what you could do. You could edit, add a little, maybe another paragraph if you don't like how it turned out and you think you can make it better. But if you really like it, then you can, you know, expand on it, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. So you don't have to stop at doing a short story. If you really like how it's turning out, you can extend it longer and make it into like a full story, and then send it to a publisher and get published. Yes, good luck. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. I will try and stop saying because I don't like it when I do that. And see you next time. Next video, it's gonna be, damn it, I just said it again. It's going to be general discussion of books, and what makes a book good, and the criteria, and all that. So, thanks for watching. Good luck with your stories, and see you next time.